More than 1,000 homes have been removed from Melbourne's rental market as rising costs force landlords to sell up. Now, that's leaving renters with nowhere to go as the vacancy rate reaches an all-time low.
Everything is looking rosy at the top end of town.
It sits on one of the largest land holdings, a little over 3,600 square metres.
But for Melbourne's renters, finding a home is getting increasingly bleak.
It's just really difficult. It's an intense competition.
Close to 1,200 homes were taken off Melbourne's rental market in the past month, the state's vacancy rate plummeting to a new record low.
The housing and rental crisis is out of control.
Supply of houses for sale are considerably down on the past 3 or 4 years.
Victoria has a population of almost 7 million, but fewer than 7,000 available rental properties. This unit in Carnegie, one of the next to go, as investors sell up unable to cope with interest rate rises and new Victorian taxes.
We are selling and sold. Congratulations, well done.
There certainly has been an increase of landlords wanting to sell investment properties because the cost of maintaining them is just not worthwhile for them to retain as an investment.
Renters took their frustration to the streets of Fitzroy, slamming the state government's bold target of 800,000 new homes in 10 years, claiming it doesn't go far enough.
The Victorian government's plan is to increase supply to a level by that their own estimates don't meet demand in future.
Rent needs to be more affordable. Landlords need to be held to account and the government should provide shelter to those in need.
Kathleen O'Connor, 7 News.